Damos la gloria a Dios por todos los que están conectando con nosotros.
We give glory to God for everyone that is connecting with us.
No, bienvenido a esta sección con el Ministerio Internacional MOA.
Welcome to this session with MOA International Ministry.
Es para nosotros un privilegio estar aquí con ustedes.
It is a privilege for us to be with you.
Estamos esperando que algunas personas se empiecen a conectar. Creemos que esta sesión va a ser extraordinaria.
We are waiting for people to connect with us. We believe that this is going to be an extraordinary session. We're just inviting people. Invite someone that you think would enjoy this.
Y invita a alguien que tú crees que se va a gozar con esta palabra en el día de hoy. Compártelo si tú crees que tienes amigos que quisieran oír la palabra. Aleluya. Vamos a comenzar en los próximos dos minutos, todos los que están conectando. Sigan invitando, compartiendo el video.
Continue to share the video.
Dios está haciendo cosas poderosas.
God is doing powerful things.
A Él le damos la gloria por lo que Él está haciendo en medio nuestro.
We give Him glory for what He is doing in our midst.
Aleluya.
Share with us where you're joining from.
Comparte con nosotros de dónde te estás uniendo.
Or your name if you're on Instagram and you have a different name than your real name.
O tu nombre si tienes Instagram.
See who's with us.
¿Quién está con nosotros? ¿Quién está con nosotros?
Walters, Pastor Panta, Ebony is with us again today.
Aleluya.
Junior, Dios le bendiga. God bless you all.
Un minuto más.
We're just gonna give it another minute.
Siguen invitando personas.
Continue to invite.
Para que se unan con nosotros.
We're just getting started, so invite now so that people can. Yes, Danielle, I've been talking to Matias about
we rebuke that.
That you messaged us today. We believe that God is going to do a powerful work in you and with you.
In the name of Jesus, there's no weapon formed against you that shall be able to prosper, woman of God.
Let's see.
Hallelujah.
Let me log in so that I can see.
My man Frank, God bless you, man. God bless you, man of God, man. I heard your CD. Praise God.
Wow, Pastor Panta, all the way from East Africa, Tanzania.
Pastor, Tanzania. God bless you. God bless you. All those who are connected with us tonight.
Let me just log in so I can.
God bless you guys. Dios le bendiga. Todo lo que están conectando, everyone that's connecting, we bless you in the name of the Lord. Praise God for what He's doing in our midst.
Conectando. Te bendiga en el nombre del Señor.
Hallelujah. This is truly an awesome time.
Should we try for you to do English today and I'll translate into Spanish?
Hallelujah.
Just kidding.
Damos la gloria a Dios por tu vida.
All right. Let's see. Who do we have? Vanessa Colón. God bless you. Adelaida. Our faithful friends. Danielle, here's your message. I'm watching from the hospital bed, declaring His word over my life, blaring worship music since I've arrived. Pulse ox was 92-93, now up to 98%. I anticipate my discharge. Glory to God. I'm telling you, Danielle, you are in that hospital just to testify of the goodness of God.
Amen to that.
Because this woman, if you guys know my friend Danielle, she is a powerhouse for the kingdom.
Man of God, I heard it. I heard it, man. Frank, I heard it.
Nieve,
I was shocked.
Bendiga.
God is doing the work
Pastor
with you,
Panta.
Man. And we're always here, Frank, at 4 p.m. every day, live. Estamos aquí siempre a las 4 de la tarde, en vivo.
Maria Rodriguez, Dios le bendiga. Marta, Yanni Taveras, Dios bendiga, pido oración por República Dominicana. Matias has been trying to get to DR.
Amen, amen. Estamos tratando de llegar. Vamos a comenzar.
And, oh, Jesse. Pastor Panta, you need to pray that these doors are open because we have a trip scheduled in Tanzania.
Yes, we do. We got to go to Tanzania.
We're going to Tanzania to bless the people. When was that scheduled for? October?
September,
October. So it's still in the books. Make sure you're following our dates because we're going to be in your country and we want to see you there. Eva Torres.
New London, Connecticut is in the house. I see. Love you. Amen, Vanessa.
Oh, Vanessa, I didn't know you were from New London.
Yes, New London. Hi, Eva. Eva Torres. Hey, God bless you, woman of God.
I was telling my husband about you last night because of the book order. And I'm like, you know, Eva, I'm like the one who's like powerful and always receiving word. And
yes, yes. She was telling me about you.
And he's like, oh, yeah, I know her. She's an awesome
Dios bendiga, Dios bendiga, Francisco. Bendiciones, Príncipe del Señor.
She's good people.
Let's get started. Vamos a comenzar. Right. Dios está haciendo algo poderoso en medio nuestro.
God is doing powerful things in our midst. I'm just excited today. Tell them, I've just been like so full of joy.
Dios, ella está llena del gozo de Dios en el día de hoy.
It's just, I don't know. It's been a supernatural day.
Este ha sido un día sobrenatural. Le damos la gloria a Dios por lo que Él está haciendo.
I'm just, yeah. We give glory Rose, to God for what He is doing. Ross.
Bendiciones.
Wendy,
amen, amen. There's so many new people connecting. Hay tanta persona nueva que están conectando.
Yes.
We thank God for you all. Le damos la gracia de por cada. Okay, let's go into the word. Vamos a entrar en la palabra del Señor.
Eva, I love Eva. She's like one of my faves.
Okay, vamos a entrar en la palabra del Señor.
Let us enter into the word of the Lord.
Vamos a ir a la palabra para...
And it's part 7 today.
Parte 7.
Let us go into the word for part 7.
Hechos capítulo 4, verso 4.
Acts verse 4 in chapter 4.
Hechos 4.
Janine is here.
Aleluya.
We're just getting started. You're right on time. She knows.
Aleluya. Pero muchos de los que habían oído la palabra creyeron. Y el número de los varones era como de 5,000.
However, many of them which heard the word believed, and the number of the men was about 5,000.
Vamos a orar.
Let's pray.
Padre, en el nombre de Jesús, te damos gracias por todo lo que están conectados.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray for all of those who are connected.
Bendecimos su vida ahora en el nombre de Jesús.
Bless their lives right now in the name of
Jesus. Y te pedimos que tú te muevas por tu Santo Espíritu.
And we pray that you would move by your Holy Spirit.
De una forma poderosa.
In a powerful way.
Te damos la gloria y la honra.
We give you the glory and the honor.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Amén y amén.
Amen and amen.
Queremos hablarte bajo el título.
We want to speak to you under the title. Titanic theme. Or you changing it up?
Fe Titánica, parte 7.
Titanic Faith, part 7.
Hemos estado haciendo esta serie. Hay tanta persona nueva que están conectando hoy.
There's a lot of new people who are connecting with us. And all of our old friends. I just saw Patona Hannah.
Prophet Blake.
Rikia.
I bless you in the name of the Lord.
Our friend Rikia.
I bless Prophet Blake. That's my man. I love you, man. You know I love you. De nuevo, hay tanta persona. Okay, vamos a entrar.
Thank you for connecting with us.
Gracias por conectarse.
We have a powerful word for you today.
Okay, lo que yo quiero hablarte bajo el título, una fe titánica parte 7.
We want to talk to you under the title, under the theme, Titanic Faith Part 7.
Esta serie se ha tratado de edificar tu confianza.
This series has been talking about or has been about increasing your faith. Your confidence.
Incrementar tu confianza.
Increasing your confidence.
Lo que Dios está haciendo en cada uno de nosotros.
What God has been doing in each one of us.
A través de este tiempo.
Through this time.
Es que Él está edificando nuestra confianza.
Is that He is increasing our confidence.
La palabra dice en Primera de Juan capítulo 5.
The word says in 1 John verse 5.
Primera de Juan capítulo 5.
1 John chapter 5.
Y esta es la confianza que tenemos en Él.
And this is the confidence that we have in Him.
Dios quiere que nosotros tengamos confianza en Él.
God wants us to have confidence in Him.
Y la palabra nos enseña que la fe viene por el oír.
And the word teaches us that faith comes by hearing.
Y oír la palabra de Dios.
And hearing the word of God.
La confianza es la fe.
Confidence is faith.
Cuando tú estás operando en fe, hay un denuedo que se desarrolla en ti.
When you're operating in faith, there is a boldness that operates in you.
Y Dios quiere ese denuedo que se desarrolle en cada uno de nosotros.
And God wants this boldness to develop in every single one of you.
Para que nosotros entremos a otro nivel.
So that we will enter into a new level.
Cada persona que se está conectando con nosotros en el día de hoy.
Every single person that's connecting with us today.
Yo quiero que tú entiendas algo.
I want you to understand.
El enemigo está atacando la fe de los creyentes.
The enemy is attacking the faith of the believers.
Él está atacando al mundo.
He is attacking the world.
Pero en sí lo que él está atacando de los creyentes es la fe.
But the thing that he is attacking in the believers is their faith.
Entonces nosotros tenemos que desarrollar una fe poderosa.
And so we are trying to develop a powerful faith.
Nosotros estamos en vivo todos los días para que tú te conectes con una palabra para desarrollar tu confianza.
We are live every single day so that you can develop a faith and a confidence in the word.
Ahí a donde tú estás.
Right where you are.
Dios te está llamando a otro nivel de confianza.
God is calling you to another level of confidence.
Hoy yo estaba leyendo la historia de Abraham.
Today I was reading the story of Abraham.
Y le estaba explicando a mi esposa.
And I was explaining to my wife.
Que la verdadera adoración.
That true worship
es cuando tú tienes confianza en Dios, no importando las circunstancias.
Is when you have confidence in God, no matter what the circumstances.
La palabra dice.
The word says.
La hora viene y ya es.
The hour will come and is now.
Que los verdaderos adoradores adorarán al Padre en espíritu y en verdad.
When the true worshipers will worship in spirit and in truth.
Nosotros estamos en esa hora ahora mismo.
We are in this hour right now.
A donde se van a notar los verdaderos adoradores.
Where we will see who the true worshipers are.
¿Quiénes son los que están adorando en espíritu y en verdad?
Who are the ones who are worshiping in spirit and truth?
La palabra nos enseña.
The word teaches
que Abraham le dijo a sus siervos.
That Abraham said to his servants,
cuando él iba a sacrificar su hijo,
when he was going to sacrifice his son,
quédense aquí.
Stay here.
Yo y el joven vamos a adorar y vamos a venir.
The youth and I are going to go worship and will return.
Él estaba diciendo a ellos.
He was saying to them.
Que él iba a adorar.
That he was going to worship.
Él iba a sacrificar su hijo.
He was going to sacrifice his son.
Pero él le llamó adoración.
But he called it worship.
Lo que nosotros podemos ver a través de esta historia.
What we can see through this story.
Es el nivel de confianza que este hombre tenía.
Is the level of confidence this man has.
Él dijo, yo y Isaac vamos a ir y vamos a volver.
He said, Isaac and I, we're going to go and we are going to come back.
Él estaba decretando por fe.
He was declaring it by faith.
Con su boca.
With his mouth.
Que todo iba a estar bien.
That everything was going to be okay.
Él tenía una confianza puesta en la promesa de Dios.
He had a confidence by the word of God.
Él estaba establecido en la confianza de la palabra.
He was established in his confidence of the word.
Y así nosotros tenemos que estar agarrados de la promesa de Dios.
And that's how we need to hold on to the promises of the word of God.
Para nosotros entonces poder movernos hacia adelante.
For us to be able to move forward.
Así como se movió Abraham.
The way that Abraham moved forward.
No importa lo que esté pasando en tu vida.
It doesn't matter what is passing in your life.
Hay muchos cambios que están ocurriendo en este momento.
There are a lot of changes that are happening right now.
Pero lo que Dios quiere de nosotros,
but what God wants from us,
lo que Él está buscando de nosotros,
what He is seeking from us,
es que nosotros nos agarremos de su promesa,
is that we grab on to His promises,
y tengamos nuestra plena confianza en Él,
and that we have our full confidence in Him.
Dice la palabra,
the word says,
que mientras los apóstoles estaban predicando,
that while the apostles were preaching,
dice que muchos creyeron.
It says that many believe.
En Hechos 4, verso 4. Muchos creyeron.
In Acts 4:4, it says many believed.
Muchos creyeron.
Many believed.
No todos se atrevieron a creer.
Not all came to believe.
Pero muchos creyeron.
But many believed.
Y eso es lo que Dios quiere, que nosotros agarremos su palabra y que creamos.
And that is what God wants us, to grab onto the word and believe it.
No todo el mundo va a creer como nosotros estamos creyendo.
Not all the world is going to believe the way that we believe.
No te preocupes por todo el mundo.
Don't worry about the whole
Tú
world.
Tú tienes que estar enfocado en que tú estés bien en la fe.
You need to be focused that you are good in the faith.
No te preocupes de la gente que está alrededor tuyo.
Don't worry about the people who are around you.
Hasta que tú no estés fundado en Dios.
Until you are founded in God.
Tú no puedes agarrar a nadie más.
You can't grab anyone else.
Tú tienes que primeramente sembrarte tú.
You first need to ground yourself.
Y después de ahí tú sales a ayudar a otro.
And from there you can grow and help other people.
¿Qué va a ser esta palabra en tu vida?
What will this word do in your
Cuando
life?
Cuando tú te agarras de la promesa.
When you grab onto the promise.
Esta palabra, agarra esto, número uno, esta palabra te va a purificar.
Grab this, number one, the word will purify you.
La palabra te va a purificar.
The word will purify you.
Cuando tú te agarras de la promesa.
When you grab onto the promise.
Tú te das cuenta de todas las áreas de tu vida que están fuera del orden de Dios.
You start to see all of the parts of your life that are outside of the will of God.
Tú te das cuenta de cómo tú estás hablando fuera del orden de Dios.
You start seeing how you're talking out of the order of God.
Tú te das cuenta como tú estás pensando fuera del orden de Dios.
You start seeing how you're thinking outside of the
si
word of God.
Si tú te agarras de esta promesa,
if you grab onto this promise,
tú vas a ser purificado.
You will be purified.
A este tiempo en la tierra ahora mismo.
And this time in the world right now.
Hay una purificación que está pasando.
There is a purification that's happening.
Que está sacudiendo la tierra entera.
That is shaking the whole earth.
El mundo entero está siendo sacudido.
The whole world is being shaken right now.
Cuando algo es sacudido,
when something is shaken,
lo que no está estable es eliminado.
Whatever is not stable will be eliminated.
Y solamente la sustancia es lo que queda.
And only that which has substance will remain.
Dios está sacudiendo la tierra.
God is shaking the earth.
Pero es para que quede la sustancia.
But it is so that the substance will stand.
Ahí a donde tú estás.
Right there where you
are. Tienes que entender,
you need to understand,
que Dios te está purificando.
That God is purifying.
Dios te está llevando a otra dimensión.
God is taking you to another dimension.
Él está quitando todo lo que está en tu corazón que no es fe.
He is taking everything out of your heart that is not faith.
Toda duda él la está eliminando.
All doubt he is eliminating.
Todo lo que está cogiendo su lugar él lo está removiendo.
Everything that is trying to take God's place is being removed.
Y por eso es que hay tantos cambios.
And that is why there have been so many changes.
Porque todo lo que está en la tierra es temporal.
Because everything that is on the earth is temporal.
Lo único eterno es Dios y su palabra.
The only thing that is eternal is God and his word.
Entonces él nos removió todo lo temporal.
And so he has removed all of the temporal.
Y a él está enseñándonos a nosotros que lo único que tiene importancia es él.
And he is teaching us that the only thing that has importance is him.
Porque él es lo único que es eterno.
Why is he the only thing that is eternal?
Porque él es lo único que es eterno.
Because he is the only thing that is eternal.
Él quiere que nosotros tengamos la perspectiva correcta.
He wants us to have the right perspective.
Las cosas van a comenzar a abrirse.
The things are going to start to open up again.
Hay cosas que van a comenzar a ir a su normalidad.
There are things that are going to start to go back to their normality.
Pero la razón por la cual esto ha pasado.
But the reason why this has passed.
Porque Dios quiere que tú ponga el orden en espíritu y en verdad.
Because God wants you to put order back into spirit and truth.
Él quiere que tú camines desde adentro para afuera.
He wants you to walk from the inside out.
Hay demasiada gente que han estado caminando desde afuera para adentro.
There are too many people who have been walking from the outside in.
Tú tienes que caminar desde adentro para afuera.
You need to be walking from the inside out.
Por eso fue que Dios quitó todo lo que está afuera.
That's why God took away everything that's outside.
Porque él quiere dejarte saber que la única forma de verdaderamente caminar
because he wanted to show you that the only way to truly walk
es de adentro para afuera.
It's from the inside out.
Tú tienes que reinar desde tu espíritu.
You need to reign from your spirit.
Tú tienes que ser una reina desde tu espíritu.
You need to be a king or queen from your spirit.
Tú tienes que moverte desde tu espíritu.
You need to move out of your spirit.
Y había demasiadas cosas que estaban en el lugar del espíritu de Dios.
There were too many things that were taking the place of the spirit of God.
Y Dios la movió.
And God removed it.
Para que nosotros volvamos a tener la perspectiva correcta.
So that we would return to see the correct perspective.
Para que nosotros vivamos en el orden correcto.
So that we would live in the correct order.
Dios te está poniendo en el lugar de la fe.
God,
Él te está trayendo de nuevo al lugar de la fe.
God is bringing back the place of faith.
Él te está trayendo a un lugar a donde tú tienes que creerle a Él.
He's bringing you to a place where you have to believe in Him.
Todo lo que nosotros teníamos como seguro.
Everything that we had that was secure,
Dios lo movió.
God moved it.
Y Él dijo, lo único seguro,
and He said, the only thing that is secure
soy yo.
Is me.
Y tú tienes que poner tu fe en mí.
And you need to put your faith in me.
Tú tienes que creerme a mí.
You need to believe in me.
Tú tienes que mantenerte en mi palabra.
You need to keep yourself in my word.
Porque esta palabra no está purificando.
Because this word purifies.
Oye, ve conmigo a la palabra.
Go with me to the word.
En Juan 15:3.
In John 15:3.
Ya vosotros estáis limpios por la palabra que os he hablado.
Now you are clean through the word which I have spoken.
Déjame leerte el verso 2.
Let me read to you verse 2.
Todo pámpano que en mí no lleva fruto lo quitará, y todo aquel que lleva fruto lo limpiará para que lleve más fruto.
Every branch in me that bears not fruit, He taketh away. And every branch that bears fruit, He purges it, that it may bring forth more fruit.
Déjame decirte algo allá donde tú estás.
Let me tell you something right where you are.
Y yo quiero que tú ponga atención.
And I want you to pay attention.
El avivamiento más grande que tú has visto.
The biggest revival that you have ever seen.
Se aproxima pronto.
Is coming soon.
Déjame repetírtelo.
Let me repeat it.
Uno de los moveres más grandes que tú has visto se aproxima rápido.
One of the biggest moves of God that you have ever seen is coming quickly.
Una de las cosechas más grandes de almas que tú has visto se aproxima rápido.
One of the biggest harvest of souls that we have ever seen is right around the corner.
Y tú dices, Matías, ¿cómo tú estás seguro?
And you say, Matías, how are you sure of it?
Porque cuando alguien, mira lo que dice la palabra.
Because when someone, look at what the word says.
Nosotros somos los pámpanos.
We are the branches.
Y cuando alguien no lleva fruto.
And when someone's not bearing fruit.
Él lo quita.
He takes it away.
Hay personas que han sido removidas.
There are people who have been removed.
Hay cosas que han sido removidas.
There are things that have been removed.
Pero dice la palabra.
But the word says.
Al que lleva fruto.
The one who brings fruit.
Hablándole a la iglesia.
Speaking to the church.
Él la limpia.
He will clean it.
Para que lleve más fruto.
So that it will bring forth.
Había muchas cosas que estaban alrededor de nosotros que teníamos que limpiar.
There was a lot of stuff around us that we needed to clean out.
Y no nos dejaban operar en fe.
And it was not allowing us to operate in faith.
No nos dejaban operar en poder.
It wasn't allowing us to operate in power.
Dios nos está limpiando.
God is cleaning.
La razón por la que Él nos está limpiando.
The reason why He is cleaning.
Es porque Él quiere que nosotros llevemos más fruto.
It's because He wants us to bear more fruit.
Se aproxima uno de los tiempos más poderosos que nosotros hemos visto.
One of the most powerful times that we've ever seen is coming.
Porque la palabra nos está limpiando.
Because the word is cleaning us.
Está removiendo lo que no tiene que estar en ese lugar.
He's removing what doesn't need to be in the place.
Para que nosotros podamos movernos en fe.
So that we can move ourselves by faith.
Que podamos movernos en la promesa de Dios.
So that we can move ourselves in the promises of God.
Dios quiere que tú estés saturado en su palabra.
God wants you to be saturated with His word.
Y que sea solamente la palabra lo que te mueve.
And that only the word moves
que
you.
No había nada, que no haya nada más que coja ese lugar.
That nothing else will take that place.
Oye lo que dice la palabra.
Listen to what the word says.
Primera de Timoteo capítulo 4 verso 5.
1 Timothy 4:5.
Porque todo Porque por la palabra de Dios y por la oración es santificado.
For it is sanctified by the word of God and prayer.
Te lo voy a repetir de nuevo.
I'm going to repeat it again.
Porque por la palabra de Dios y la oración está santificado.
For it is sanctified by the word of God and prayer.
Tú sabes que mi mamá me estaba diciendo hoy una historia.
You know that today my mom was telling me a story.
Yo ya, mi mamá me llamó y yo cogí la llamada y estaba hablando con ella.
My mom called me and I called her back and I was talking to her.
Y ella me dijo que ella vio una caricatura, es a meme.
And she was telling me that she saw a meme.
Entre Dios y el enemigo.
Between God and the enemy.
Y el enemigo le estaba diciendo a Dios.
And the enemy was saying to God.
Hey, te cerré todas las iglesias.
He was saying, hey, I closed all the churches.
Y Dios le dijo, no, al contrario.
And God said, no, in the contrary.
Tú me abriste una iglesia en todas las casas.
You opened for me a church in every home.
Ahora la iglesia no está solamente en un edificio.
Now the church is not only in a building.
Están en todas las casas.
It's in all of the houses.
Lo que yo te estoy diciendo a ti.
What I'm telling you.
Todo lo que se ha removido.
Everything that has been removed.
Solamente no ha dejado con la palabra y con oración.
It has only left us with the word and prayer.
Y la palabra dice que todo es santificado por la palabra y la oración.
And the word tells us that everything is sanctified by the word of God and prayer.
Hay personas que nunca habían oído, nunca habían publicado algo en Facebook.
There are people who have never published anything on Facebook.
Nunca habían publicado una palabra en Facebook.
They never shared a word on Facebook.
Porque ellos no estaban acostumbrados a hacer la cosa a través de vías de tecnología.
Because they were not used to doing things through technology.
Y en este tiempo Dios lo metió en Facebook.
And on this season, God put them on Facebook.
Porque no había otra forma de predicar la palabra.
Because there was no other way to preach the word.
Y se dieron cuenta.
And they took note of that.
Que esto es una forma poderosa de comunicar el evangelio alrededor del mundo.
That this is a powerful way to communicate the word of God around the world.
Habían personas que no habían oído la palabra y no le habían ponido atención a la palabra nunca.
There are people who have never heard the word or paid attention to the word ever.
Pero ahora que todas las otras cosas están quitadas.
But now that everything else has been taken away.
Le están poniendo atención a la palabra.
They're paying attention to the word.
Están orando.
They're praying.
Porque Dios no está purificando.
Because God is purifying.
Dios no está santificando.
God is sanctifying.
Para que el avivamiento llegue.
So that the revival will come.
Para que el crecimiento de la iglesia llegue.
So that the growth of the church will come.
Es de aquí nosotros vamos a salir.
From here we are going to get out.
Santificado.
Sanctified.
Purificado.
Purified.
Para que haya un gran mover de Dios.
So that there will be a great move of God.
Te estoy diciendo ahora.
I'm telling you now.
No te atemorices.
Do not be afraid.
No te atemorices.
Don't be afraid.
Algo grande se aproxima.
Something big is coming.
Pero tú tienes que estar con denuedo.
But you need to be with boldness.
Tú tienes que moverte con confianza.
You need to move with confidence.
Porque el enemigo va a tratar de implementar temor.
Because the enemy is going to try to put fear on you.
Cuando nosotros salgamos para afuera de nuevo.
When we go outside again.
Van a ver todavía personas con máscara.
We're going to see people without masks.
Vamos a ver personas que van a estar pensando si esta persona lo tiene o no lo tiene. Van a ver personas media titubeando.
There are going to be people who are going to be wondering, does that person have it? Did they have it? Did they not? People are going to be a little worried.
Tú tienes que salir con confianza porque este es un tiempo de crecimiento.
You need to go out there with confidence because this is a season for your growth.
Cada vez que viene una purificación.
Every time a purification comes.
Cada vez que viene una limpieza.
Every time a cleansing comes.
Es para aumentar y para multiplicar.
It is to grow and to multiply.
Ahí a donde tú estás.
Right there where you are.
Dios te está limpiando.
God is cleaning you.
Te está santificando.
He's purifying you. He's sanctifying
te
you.
Te está elevando a otra dimensión.
He is raising you to another dimension.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I just thought about Jacob, how he needed to stay hidden for his breakthrough.
Dile, 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 Lidia. Go. Tell them. Lidia tiene una palabra.
Lydia has a word. No, I was just thinking about the time when Jacob sent his family ahead and he stayed in isolation. And it was in that isolation that God transformed him from Jacob to Israel.
Yo estaba pensando en el tiempo de Jacob cuando Dios lo envió, cuando Jacob se quedó solo con Jehová y envió su familia hacia adelante.
And that was the time in isolation that God transformed.
Y ese fue en el tiempo, de ese tiempo de soledad fue a donde Dios lo transformó.
From Jacob to Israel.
De Jacob a Israel.
And made him a new man.
Y lo hizo un hombre nuevo.
I believe a lot of people are becoming new men and women during this.
Yo creo que muchas personas están siendo hombres nuevos y mujeres nuevas. Amen, Lydia.
You gotta fight for it.
Tenemos que pelear por lo que Dios nos está dando.
Amen. Go ahead.
Esta palabra nos purifica.
This word purifies us.
Esta palabra nos limpia.
It cleanses us.
Para que nosotros demos más fruto.
So that we will give more fruit.
Déjame llevarte un poco más profundo.
Let me bring you a little deeper.
Después que tú estás operando,
after you are operating,
en un lugar de confianza,
in a place of confidence,
Dios te empieza a santificar.
God begins to sanctify you.
Es para que tú testifique.
It is for you to testify.
De la grandeza que él ha hecho en ti.
Of the greatness that he has done in you.
Es para que nosotros testifiquemos.
It's for us to testify.
Ve conmigo a Hechos capítulo 8, verso 25.
Go with me to Acts 8, 25.
Y ellos, habiendo testificado y hablando la palabra de Dios, se volvieron a Jerusalén y mucha población de los samaritanos anunciaron el evangelio.
And they, when they had testified and preached the word of the Lord, returned to Jerusalem and preached the gospel in many villages of the Samaritans.
Te lo voy a repetir.
I'm going to repeat it.
Y ellos, habiendo testificado y hablando la palabra de Dios, se volvieron a Jerusalén y mucha población de los samaritanos anunciaron el evangelio de Dios.
And they, when they had testified and preached the word of the Lord, returned to Jerusalem and preached the gospel in many villages of the Samaritans.
Ponme atención por algunos minutos.
Give me your attention for a couple of minutes.
Estos dos personajes de los cuales la Biblia está hablando en este lugar.
These two people in which the word is talking about in this
Él está place. Hablando de Pedro y de Juan.
It is talking about Peter and John.
Pedro y Juan.
Peter and John.
Son los que son enviados a Samaria.
Were the ones who were sent to Samaria.
Y yo quiero que tú entiendas.
And I want you to understand.
Felipe había sido enviado a Samaria por el Espíritu de Dios.
Philip was sent to Samaria by the Spirit of God.
Todo el mundo había venido a Cristo.
All of them had come to Christ.
Pero todavía no habían sido llenos con el Espíritu Santo.
But they still had not been filled with the Holy Spirit.
Entonces mandaron a llamar a Pedro y a Juan.
And so he had called for Peter and John.
Y cuando ellos vinieron,
and when they came,
ellos pusieron la mano sobre los que habían aceptado al Señor.
They put their hands on the ones who had accepted the Lord.
Y todos ellos fueron llenos del Espíritu Santo.
And all of them were filled with the Holy Spirit.
Ahora yo quiero que tú me pongas atención.
And so now I want you to pay attention.
Porque esta palabra primero te purifica.
Because this word first purifies
you. Y tú dices, después que te purifica.
And then you say, after it purifies you.
Te manda a impactar y a testificar.
It sends you to testify, to... I'm sorry, say those two again.
Para impactar.
To impact.
Y testificar.
And testify.
Déjame explicártelo de esta forma.
Let me explain it to you this way.
Oye, ¿cuáles fueron los dos personajes?
Listen, who were the two people?
Que Dios usó para ir a Samaria.
That God used to go to Samaria.
Para que todo el mundo sea lleno con el poder de Dios.
So that all the people there would be filled with the Spirit of God.
Pedro.
Peter.
Y Juan.
And John.
Pedro tenía un problema.
Peter had a problem
con su furia o su enojo.
with his anger.
Él tenía un problema grave.
He had a serious problem.
No era cualquier tipo de problema.
It wasn't just some sort of problem.
Él tenía un problema con la actitud de él y su.
He had a problem with his attitude.
Y tenía un problema con su emociones.
And with his emotions.
Que él no podía controlar su furia.
That he could not control his anger.
Por eso fue que delante de la presencia de Jesús.
That is why before the presence of Jesus.
Él le cortó la oreja a alguien.
He cut off someone's ear.
Pero no solamente él tenía un problema con la furia.
But he didn't just have a problem with his anger.
Él tenía un problema con consistencia.
He had a problem with consistency.
Un día él estaba con Jesús.
One day he was with Jesus.
Y el otro día no estaba con Jesús.
And the next day he wasn't with Jesus.
Un día él estaba caminando sobre las aguas.
One day he was walking on the water.
Y el otro día se estaba hundiendo.
And the next moment he was drowning.
Él no era consistente.
He was not consistent.
Un día tenía una revelación de que este es el Cristo.
One day he had a revelation that this is the Christ.
Y el otro día lo estaba negando.
And the next day he was denying.
Lo que nosotros te estamos enseñando.
What we are teaching you.
Es que este no era un hombre.
That this was a man.
Que era un hombre con muchos diferentes problemas.
He was a man with so many different problems.
También Juan el Apóstol.
And also John the Apostle.
Él tenía un problema también con sus emociones.
He also had a problem with his emotions.
Cuando a Jesús lo rechazaron.
When
una ciudad rechazó a Jesús.
When a city rejected Jesus.
Y no lo dejaron entrar.
And they didn't let them enter.
¿Tú sabes qué dijo Jacobo y Juan?
Do you know what John and
James?
James,
su hermano dijeron.
James and John, the brother, said.
¿Tú quieres que mandemos mandar fuego del cielo para que destruya todo el mundo aquí?
Should we send for fire from heaven to destroy everyone?
Estos hombres no tenían remordimiento.
These men did not have any remorse.
Estaban batallando con sus emociones.
They were battling with their emotions.
Todavía no estaban totalmente en el espíritu.
They were not yet completely in the spirit.
Dice la palabra que el Señor los reprendió.
The word says that the Lord rebuked them.
Y le dijo, yo no vine a perder la gente.
And he said to them, I didn't come to lose people.
Yo vine a ganármelos.
I came to win them.
Y le dice, ustedes no saben qué clase de espíritu está operando en ustedes.
He said, you don't know what kind of spirit is operating in you.
Porque ellos no tenían el espíritu correcto.
Because they didn't have the spirit correct. Correct spirit.
Pedro no tenía el espíritu correcto.
Peter did not have the correct spirit.
Pero, sin embargo, después que ellos fueron purificados.
But regardless, when they had been purified
por el Espíritu Santo,
by the Holy Spirit,
porque el Espíritu Santo lo había llenado de su presencia,
because the Holy Spirit then filled them with his presence,
y ellos se pusieron a meterse en la palabra,
and they began to put themselves in the word,
y ellos empezaron a orar,
and they began to pray,
ellos empezaron a agarrarse de la promesa,
they began to grab onto the promise,
Dios lo purificó,
God purified them.
Wow, ¿cómo yo sé que Dios lo purificó?
How do I know that God purified
oye,
them?
Oye lo que Dios me ha hecho con estas dos personas.
Look at what God did with these two people.
So, y hablando de los en Hechos capítulo 6.
In Acts chapter 6.
Verso 4.
Verse 4.
Hechos capítulo 6, verso 4.
Acts 6:4.
Dice, y nosotros persistiremos.
It says, but we will give ourselves continually
en la oración y el ministerio de la palabra.
To prayer and to the ministry of the word.
Ellos no querían servir mesas.
They didn't want to serve tables.
Porque ellos querían continuamente entregarse.
Because they wanted to continually give themselves.
A la oración y al ministerio de la palabra.
To prayer and the ministry of the word.
Timoteo nos dice que esa es la forma de ser santificado.
Timothy says that this is another way of being sanctified.
Cuando tú te entregas la palabra y la oración.
When you give yourself to prayer and the word.
Tú eres santificado día tras día.
You are sanctified day by day.
Estos dos hombres habían sido ahora santificado.
These two men were now sanctified.
Ellos habían sido limpiados.
They were purified.
Y ahora que habían sido limpiados,
and now that they had been cleaned,
Dios quería usarlo a ellos como instrumento.
God wanted to use them as an instrument.
Y en Hechos del capítulo 8,
and in Acts chapter 8,
ellos fueron a impactar esa región.
They went to impact this
Dios
region.
Te está purificando a ti.
God is purifying.
Él me está limpiando a mí.
He is cleaning me.
Él nos está purificando a nosotros.
He is purifying us.
Quitándonos lo que no tiene que estar ahí.
Taking away whatever doesn't need to be there.
Para que cuando nosotros salgamos de este lugar.
So that when we get out of this place.
Yo quiero que tú entiendas.
I want you to understand.
Nosotros estamos en un tiempo profético.
We are in a prophetic time.
Ahora mismo nosotros estamos en el tiempo de Pentecostés.
Right now we are in the time of Pentecost.
Nosotros estamos todos. Estamos en un lugar secreto.
We are all right now in a secret place.
Tenemos que estar, estamos encerrados.
We are closed in.
¿Tú sabes por qué estamos encerrados?
Do you know why we're closed
Porque
in?
Estamos esperando un derramamiento.
Because we are waiting for an outpouring.
Nosotros estamos esperando un mover del Espíritu de Dios.
We are waiting for a spirit of the move of God.
Estamos esperando algo que se derrame sobre nosotros.
We are waiting for something to outpour over us.
Cuando tú eres limpiado,
when you are purified,
cuando tú eres santificado,
when you are sanctified,
el Espíritu Santo se prepara para depositar algo nuevo en ti.
The Holy Spirit is getting you ready for him to deposit something new in you.
Para que cuando tú salgas,
so that when you get out,
prepárense porque vamos a salir.
Prepare yourself because we're going to get out.
Cuando tú salgas,
when you get out,
este es el tiempo de preparación.
This is the time of preparation.
Te lo voy a repetir.
I'm going to repeat it.
Este es el tiempo de agarrarse de la promesa.
This is the time to grab onto the promise.
Este es el tiempo de estar buscando la presencia de Dios.
This is the time to grab onto the presence of God.
Y cuando tú salgas,
and when you get out,
tú vas a salir con el poder de Dios.
You're going to get out with the power of God.
Tú vas a salir empoderado con la gloria de Dios.
You are going to get out with the power of God.
La gloria de Dios.
The glory of God.
Y tú vas a impactar a la persona con la cual tú te encuentres.
And you are going to impact the people that you are going to encounter.
Ellos fueron a Samaria.
They went to Samaria.
Ellos fueron a Samaria.
They went to Samaria.
Tú tienes que entender, eso es profético.
You need to understand this is prophetic.
Ellos fueron a Samaria.
They went to Samaria.
Los judíos no querían saber de los samaritanos.
The Jews did not want anything to do with the Samaritans.
Y ellos fueron a Samaria.
And they went to Samaria.
Y todo el mundo fue lleno con el Espíritu de Dios.
And everyone there was filled with the Spirit of God.
Y ellos no salieron de una vez.
And they didn't get out all at one time.
No salieron de una vez. Ellos no se fueron de una vez.
And it didn't happen all at once.
No se fueron. Ellos no se fueron de una vez. Los apóstoles.
The apostles didn't go.
No salieron de Samaria de una vez. They didn't leave Samaria right away.
They didn't leave Samaria right away.
Ellos se quedaron en Samaria.
They stayed in Samaria.
Y dice la palabra.
And the word says.
Ándate el verso que leímos.
It was Acts 8:25. And when they had testified.
Y habiendo testificado y hablando la palabra, se volvieron a Jerusalén. Y muchos población de los samaritanos anunciaron el evangelio.
Acts 8:25 says, and they, when they had testified and preached the word of the Lord, returned to Jerusalem and preached the gospel in many villages of the Samaritans.
Ellos estaban testificando en muchos lugares de los
they were testifying in many places
de las poblaciones de los samaritanos.
In the villages of the Samaritans.
Ellos habían sido totalmente transformados.
They were completely transformed.
Una gente que no querían saber de los samaritanos.
A people who did not want to know about the Samaritans.
Anterior a esta purificación.
Before this purification.
Antes de que ellos sean limpiados.
Before they were purified.
Ellos no querían saber de los samaritanos.
They didn't want to know about, they didn't want to anything to do with
pero ahora ellos habían sido cambiados.
But now they had been changed.
Ellos habían sido transformados.
They were transformed.
Y eso es lo que Dios está haciendo con nosotros.
And that is what God is doing with us now.
Dios nos está transformando.
God is transforming.
Nosotros estamos cambiando.
God is changing.
Para
us.
Que nosotros salgamos con poder.
So that we will get out with power.
Este es el tiempo de preparación.
This is a time of preparation.
Para que salgamos con otro nivel de espíritu.
So that we would get out with another level of spirit. spirit.
Para que salgamos con una doble porción.
So that we will leave with a double portion.
Este es el tiempo de agarrarte de la promesa de Dios.
This is a time for us to grab on to the promises of God.
Y no movamos hasta que Dios deposite algo poderoso en nosotros.
And do not move until God has deposited something powerful in us.
Esta palabra te purifica.
This word purifies.
Esta palabra te envía a testificar.
This word will send you to testify.
Para que tú seas un impacto al mundo.
So that you will be an impact to the world.
Este es el tiempo de tener de nuevo en la palabra de Dios.
This is a time to have boldness in the word of God.
De nuevo en la palabra de Dios.
Boldness in the word of God.
Tenemos que reclamar todo lo que la palabra de Dios tiene para nosotros.
We need to claim everything that the word of God has for us. Thank you, Lord.
Con esto te voy a dejar.
With this, I'm going to close. If you didn't see this one and you're just logging in, watch from the beginning.
Oye lo que te estoy diciendo.
Listen to what I'm saying.
Estamos en un tiempo profético.
We are in a prophetic time.
Y solamente la gente que tienen de nuevo.
And only the people who have boldness.
Que se han agarrado de la promesa.
Who have grabbed on to the promises.
Van a ser un impacto para el mundo.
Are going to be an impact to the world.
Cuando las puertas del mundo se abran de nuevo.
When the doors of the world open again.
Estamos en un tiempo de preparación.
We are in a time of preparation.
Con esto te voy a dejar.
With this I'm going to leave you.
Esta promesa te entrega de nuevo.
This promise brings boldness.
En Hechos 4:29.
In Acts 4:29.
Hechos 4:29.
Acts 4:29.
Oye la oración de los apóstoles.
Listen to the prayer of the apostles.
Ahora que nosotros estamos en oración. Ahora que nosotros estamos en un lugar cerrado
now
de oración.
Now that we are in a place closed in of prayer.
Nosotros, tú no puedes estar saliendo, moviéndote mucho.
You can't be going out and moving a lot.
Es un tiempo de preparación en oración.
It is a time for preparation in prayer.
Oye la oración de los apóstoles.
Listen to the prayer of the apostles.
Esta oración la oraron.
This.
El apóstol Juan y el apóstol Pedro con todos los doctores.
The apostle John and the apostle Peter with all of the doctors of the law.
Con todos los otros apóstoles.
With all of the other apostles.
Estamos en un tiempo profético.
We are in a prophetic time.
Oye la oración que nosotros tenemos que estar haciendo.
Listen to the prayer that we need to be doing.
Vamos a comenzar en el verso 28.
We're going to start in verse 28.
Y ahora, Señor, mira sus amenazas. Y concede a tu siervo que con todo de nuevo. Verso 28, perdona. Para hacer cuanto tu mano y consejo habían antes determinado que sucediera. Y ahora, Señor, mira sus amenazas y concede a tu siervo que con todo de nuevo hablen tu palabra.
For to do whatsoever thy hand and thy counsel determined before to be done. And now, Lord, behold their threatenings, and grant unto your servants that with all boldness they may speak thy word.
Ellos dijeron, Señor, mira las amenazas de lo que están viniendo en contra de tu palabra.
They are saying, Lord, look at the threatenings that are coming against your word.
Y dale a tus siervos.
And give your servants.
Todo de nuevo para que hablen tu palabra.
All boldness that they may speak your word.
Dale de nuevo para que hablen tu palabra.
Give us boldness so that we may speak your word.
Mientras, verso 30, mientras extiende tus manos para que se hagan sanidad y señales y prodigios mediante el nombre de tu santo Hijo Jesús.
Verse 30 says, by stretching forth thy hand to heal, and that signs and wonders may be done by the name of thy holy child Jesus.
Este es el tiempo en el cual nosotros estamos.
This is the time in which we are.
Nosotros tenemos que estar orando esa oración.
We need to be praying this prayer.
Y prepararnos para cuando todo esto se abra.
And preparing ourselves for when everything opens.
Cuando esto se abra, nosotros tenemos que estar listos para ver el mover de Dios.
When this opens, we need to be ready to see the move of God.
Oye lo que dice la palabra.
Listen to what the word says.
Esta, la promesa de Dios.
The promise of God
está en esta palabra.
Is in this word.
Dale a tu siervo de nuevo.
Give your servants boldness.
Para que hablen tu palabra.
To speak your word.
Mientras extiendes tu mano para que se hagan sanidades, señales y prodigios.
By stretching forth thine hand to heal and that signs and wonders may be done.
Esa tiene que ser nuestra oración.
This needs to be our prayer.
Porque de ahí va a salir una cosecha de almas como nunca antes.
Because from there will come a harvest of souls like we've never seen before.
Esta fue la oración que ellos hicieron.
This was the prayer that they did.
Cuando las cosas se le pusieron difícil alrededor de ellos.
When things got difficult around them.
Ellos hicieron esa oración.
They did this prayer.
Cuando habían amenazas en contra de ellos.
When there were threatenings against
them. Ahora mismo el pueblo de Dios está bajo amenaza del coronavirus.
Right now, the people of God are being threatened by coronavirus.
Y están bajo amenaza de los planes del diablo en contra del mover de la iglesia.
And they are being threatened by the plan of the enemy that is moving against the church.
Nosotros tenemos que llenarnos de nuevo para hablar la palabra.
We need to move in boldness again to preach the word.
Y para que Dios estreche con sanidad de su mano, milagros, prodigios y señales.
And that the Lord will stretch out his hand with healing, signs, and wonders.
Es tiempo de que nosotros caminemos con denuedo.
It is time for us to walk with boldness.
Como nunca antes.
Like never before.
No temas a nada.
Do not fear anything.
Que Dios lo que va a hacer.
That what God is going to do.
Él lo va a hacer con personas que tienen confianza en Él.
He's going to do it with people who have confidence in Him.
Gente que han cogido su palabra.
People who have taken his word.
Y no van a ser movidos por nada más.
And will not be moved by anything else.
Aparte de la palabra de Dios.
Apart from the word of God.
Ahí a donde tú estás.
Right there where you are.
Ponte la mano en el corazón.
Put your hand on your heart.
Mañana será la última sección.
Tomorrow is going to be the last section.
De esta serie.
Of this series.
De fe titánica.
Of Titanic faith.
Una fe titánica.
A titanic faith.
Una fe con confianza en Dios.
A faith with confidence in God.
No importando lo que venga.
It doesn't matter who comes.
No importando la situación.
It doesn't matter the situation.
Nosotros vamos a movernos en fe en Dios.
We need to move ourselves in faith in God.
Allá donde tú estás.
Right there where you are.
Ponte la mano en el corazón.
Put your hand on your heart.
Para que reciba de nuevo.
So that you will receive boldness.
Padre, en el nombre de Jesús.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
Yo decreto por el poder del Espíritu Santo.
I decree by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Que cada persona que se ha conectado con nosotros.
That every person that has connected with us.
Recibe de nuevo.
Receives boldness.
Recibe de nuevo.
Receives boldness.
Recibe fe.
Receives faith.
Para entrar a otra dimensión.
To enter into a new dimension.
Entendemos que proféticamente.
We understand that prophetically.
Nosotros estamos en un tiempo para elevar nuestra unción y nuestra confianza.
We are in a time to elevate our anointing and faith.
Para que nosotros podamos ser de mayor impacto.
So that we can be a greater impact.
Y para que podamos tocar más personas.
And so that we can touch more people.
Cuando las puertas del mundo se abran de nuevo.
When the doors of the world have opened again.
Entendemos que es el tiempo de Pentecostés.
We understand that this is a time of Pentecost.
Es un tiempo de cosecha.
This is a time of harvest.
A donde tu espíritu va a ser derramado.
Where your spirit is going to be poured out.
Y miles de almas vendrán a Cristo de una forma extraordinaria.
And thousands of souls will come to Christ in an extraordinary way.
Lo decretamos y lo creemos en el nombre de
Jesús.
We
declare it and we believe it in the name of Jesus.
Allá donde tú estás.
Right there where you are.
Si tú no has recibido al Señor como tu Salvador personal.
If you have not yet received Christ as your Lord and Savior.
Yo quiero orar por ti.
I want to pray for you.
La única forma de que tú entres en la fe de Dios.
The only way for you to enter into the faith of God.
Es que tú aceptes a Jesús como tu único Salvador.
is for you to accept Christ as your only Savior.
Él es el único nombre dado a los hombres por lo cual los hombres pueden ser salvos.
He is the only name given to men by which men can be saved.
Ahí a donde tú estás.
Right there where you are.
Repite tu oración conmigo.
Repeat this prayer with me.
Di, Señor,
say, Lord,
perdóname.
Forgive me.
Por mi pecado.
For my sins.
Yo quiero servirte.
I want to serve you.
En espíritu.
In spirit.
En alma.
In soul.
Y en cuerpo.
And in body.
Yo confieso con mi boca.
I confess with my mouth.
Y yo creo en mi corazón.
And I believe in my heart
que Jesús murió por mí,
that Jesus died for me,
para que yo le sirva a él,
so that I can serve him,
en espíritu y en libertad,
in spirit and in liberty,
en el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Amén y amén.
Amen.
Si tú hiciste esa oración por primera vez,
if you said this prayer for the first time,
conéctate con nosotros de inmediato.
Connect with us immediately.
Porque queremos ayudarte.
Because we want to help you.
A darte el próximo paso para ser discipulado.
To give you the next step to be discipled.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Amén y amén.
Amen and amen.
Empiecen a enviar sus peticiones de oración.
Begin to share your prayer requests.
Envíen sus peticiones.
Share any prayer requests that you have to
envíen
lift up.
Testimonios.
Share us any testimonies that you may have.
Que queremos orar por ti.
So that we can pray for you.
Nos estamos preparando para levantar la ofrenda.
We are getting ready to lift an offering.
Vamos a poner la información, Lidia, para que las personas puedan.
Right here.
Amén.
This one?
Mm-hmm.
The orange one. Anyone that has prayer requests that needs prayer. If you're just logging on, watch from the beginning so that you can understand and grow your faith.
Si tú te estás conectando ahora, mira el mensaje desde el comienzo para que tú puedas edificar tu fe. Aleluya. Dios está haciendo cosas poderosas.
God is doing powerful things.
Ahí a donde tú estás.
Right where you are.
La palabra nos enseña que tenemos que ser dadores alegre.
The word teaches us that we need to be cheerful givers.
Y queremos darte una oportunidad.
And we want to give you an opportunity.
Para conectarte con este ministerio.
To connect you with this ministry.
Échate para acá, Lidia.
Yeah,
para
I'm
Está bien.
I'm good.
¿Estás segura?
It's a little, see that's why I made it a little opaque.
Okay.
Yeah.
Te queremos dar una oportunidad.
We want to give you an opportunity.
De conectarte con el ministerio.
To connect you with our ministry.
Y de sembrar al Señor una semilla.
And to sow a seed into the Lord.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Vamos a orar.
We're going to pray.
Padre, en el nombre de Jesús.
Father, in the name of Jesus,
te damos gracias por cada dador alegre.
We give thanks for every cheerful giver.
Te pedimos que tú te muevas por tu Santo Espíritu.
We pray that you will move by your Holy Spirit.
En cada dador alegre.
In every cheerful giver.
Que tú pongas tu mano poderosa.
That you would put your powerful hand on.
Reprendemos todo plan del enemigo.
We rebuke every plan of the enemy.
Que venga en contra de su provisión y de su finanza.
That comes against their provision or their finances.
Y decretamos en el nombre de Jesús.
And we declare in the name of Jesus
que cada uno de ellos verán tu gloria,
that every one of them will see your glory
en su provisión y sus sustancias,
in their provision and their substance,
en el nombre de Jesús,
in the name of Jesus.
Amén y amén.
Amen and amen.
De nuevo, gracias por conectarse con nosotros.
Once again, thank you for connecting with us.
Compartan el video, sigan enviando.
Share the video, keep sharing it. Send us your prayer request. Thank you, Rikia. I got your message. I need to share here on Instagram. Oops. Sorry,
man. Aleluya. Estamos tratando de conectarnos y darle información en WhatsApp. Instagram.
You can message us on Instagram. We can give you other ways if you would like to sew.
Testimony.
Yeah. Rikia, testimony. I slept like a baby last night. Thank you, Jesus. I prayed that she wasn't able to sleep just yesterday.
Jesus.
Janine is encouraging people, especially if you are awake in the night. Please watch.
Jesus, Jesus, Amen. Jesus.
Vanessa had sent in to give her a little, us a little background.
Okay. She's, what's going on,
born
Vanessa?
Born and raised in New York. She's actually best friends, she says, with Tiffany. Miami's Tiffany.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Whoa, that's my
yeah,
daughter.
We love her.
We love her. That's my girl.
And so she wants prayer. She lives in Brooklyn, but she has family in Brooklyn and New London.
Okay.
And a few of her family members, both in New York and Connecticut, have been having the virus for almost a month. And so she wants prayer for them, and she thanks us for the powerful word. Oh, you're amazing too. We love you.
Amen.
I love
Vanessa.
Your engagement. We're always encouraged when we see people like, yeah, because we know that we're imparting a word that is the word. That is,
Amen, amen. Well, we're praying for that right now. Why don't you pray for that, Lydia?
Okay. Father God, I thank you for Vanessa. I thank you how you have connected her with our ministry.
Yes, Lord.
And that she is growing her faith through these messages. Lord, I pray that you would just touch her family and her friends in a powerful way. Lord, that you would not just touch their bodies, but through the word and even through Vanessa's encouragement and by her sharing the word,
in the name
that
of
their
Jesus.
Faith would increase, that
yes,
their spirits
Lord.
Would be changed. Lord, any family members
you gotta restart on Instagram
who do not know the Lord, that you would begin to work in a powerful way spiritually in them.
Yes, Lord.
That you would begin to just give her the words, give her the encouragement, and even work supernaturally through your Holy Spirit, that they would begin to seek the Lord through this time. Seek the Lord in their sickness and know that healing comes through the stripes of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, we thank you for Vanessa's life. We thank you for her growth, and we thank you for the supernatural things that you were doing both in her and Tiffany right now, that you would grow them as a unit, Lord, as friends, because two are better than one.
Amen.
So, Lord, that they would encourage each other in the faith, and that you would just do supernatural things in their lives and in their families. Amen.
Amen, 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 amen. Anyone else? Alguien más?
Janine wanted prayer. I saw prayer to find out God's will for my life.
Amen, amen. Father God, right now in the name of Jesus, I decree that you reveal your will to Janine's life, that she will not be confused in any way and in any form. I rebuke her right now in the name of Jesus, and I pray that you will do a supernatural work in her life right now. In Jesus' name, I give you the glory, the honor, and the praise for her life. In the name of Jesus, move by your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, thank you, Master, for what you're doing. Continue to move by your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, upon her life, and reveal your purposes for her in your will. In the name of Jesus, amen. And amen.
If you're joining us again on Instagram, we're just taking prayer requests.
Yes.
If you need prayer, or if you want to share a testimony.
Si alguien no está uniendo, se está uniendo con nosotros ahora, envíenos sus oraciones o sus peticiones de oración para nosotros orar por ustedes.
Or praise reports to encourage.
O envíenos si tienen algún testimonio que quieren compartir con nosotros.
Anyone else? I don't know if Danielle is still watching, but let's just pray for Danielle.
Yes, this is Danielle.
Full recovery.
Full recovery
right
in the name of your Father, in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord, we lift up the woman of God.
We lift up Danielle before you right now in Jesus' name. We thank you for that awesome woman of God, and we pray for the total recovery in her life in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
By the power of the Holy Spirit, we rebuke every weapon formed against her. We cancel it now. And we pray, Father, that she will see the manifestation of your healing in her body, because by your stripes she has been healed. And she's standing on that word, Lord. She's standing on Psalms 107, verse 20. You send your word and you heal her. And we establish it right now in the name of Jesus, by the power of the Holy Spirit, that there'll be no attack that will be able to prevail against her body from this virus. We curse it at the root.
Yes.
We curse it at the root, and we command life and breath to come into those lungs, that she wouldn't have any hard times being able to breathe. We cancel it, all every attack on her respiratory system. We cancel it in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
By the power of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, Amen and amen.
And I pray for her daughter, Michaela.
Yes, lift up Michaela.
That she would not have any fear, that she would not have any anxiety, that you would give her a supernatural peace. Lord, I pray for all of Danielle's family, her other children.
Yes,
that
Lord.
They would just start a relationship that is deeper in you.
Jesus.
Because of the testimony of her mother, that they would see how you have
yes.
continued to keep her grounded in you, and that her attitude is not changing, that her faith is growing
yes,
in the midst of
Jesus.
Adversity,
yes, Lord.
Lord, and that they would see the just the beauty that is her mother, their mother, and that you would just continue to use this for your glory
Jesus.
In every way possible, Lord, that we know that you will get the glory, the honor, and the praise for the beauty that will come out of this situation in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Just cover them.
We cover everyone under the blood of Jesus.
Anyone else have prayer requests?
Alguien
if anyone's
más.
Coming on now, listen to the word from the beginning when you have time so that you can be encouraged.
Si alguien se está conectando con nosotros, oigan la palabra desde el comienzo. Ha sido una bendición. Ha sido una bendición poderosa. Dios está haciendo cosas grandes.
Amen.
Amen. Ahí a donde ustedes están, si hay alguien más que quiere la oración.
Right there where you are, is there anyone else that needs prayer?
Conéctense con nosotros.
Connect with us.
Envíenos sus peticiones, queremos orar por ti.
Give us your prayer request because we want to pray with you.
Aleluya.
A lot of people.
Mañana vamos a tener una invitada especial.
Tomorrow we are going to have a special invited person.
Sí, vamos a tener una invitada especial con Dios por delante.
With God's will, we're going to have a guest speaker. I got the day off from translating.
I think you need to translate her. Because she's preaching in Spanish. You can do it in English. Oh. Okay, así que Dios está haciendo cosas poderosas.
God is doing powerful things.
Manténganse con nosotros. Nos van a cerrar mañana la pastora Mayra Lugo con brocha de oro.
Stay with us. Tomorrow we're going to have a special speaker, Pastora Mayra Lugo, with what's brocha?
She's gonna do a grand closure.
Oh, with a grand closure.
Sí, ella va a cerrar esta serie con de una forma poderosa. Ella va a cerrar esta serie de una forma poderosa.
She's going to close out this series in a powerful way.
Así que
Jorge had just asked, yo quiero que oren por unción y milagros.
Yo quiero que Padre, en el nombre de Jesús, oramos por Jorge, una unción fresca. Milagros que se empiecen a manifestar en su vida de una forma poderosa. Reprendemos todo plan del enemigo que trate de levantarse en contra de él. Y decretamos en el nombre de Jesús que tu poder se manifieste en su vida de una forma gloriosa y poderosa. Gracias, Señor, por lo que tú estás haciendo en su vida. Muévete para que él entre en nuevos niveles en ti por el poder del Espíritu Santo. Te damos toda la gloria y toda la honra en el nombre de Jesús. Amén. Y amén.
Amen.
Así que mañana conéctense con nosotros.
So
vamos.
Tomorrow, connect with us. Every day we're here at 4 p.m.
Estamos aquí todos los días a las 4 de la tarde.
You can watch the series from the beginning. All the videos are on our Facebook page.
Pueden ver la serie desde el comienzo. Todos los videos están en nuestra página de Facebook. Mañana a la misma hora. En el mismo lugar con
tomorrow,
una invitada especial.
Tomorrow we'll be here at the same place, same time with a special guest.
Los amamos y seguimos hacia adelante en el nombre de Jesús.
We love you and keep going forward in the name of Jesus.
Amén y amén.
Amen and amen.